There we go. That's a better fish.
There you go.
Way to go. Give it a little tail walk. Oh, dig, 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 dig. That's a mad fish. I saw her come out and eat it. She was definitely hungry. She kept slowly sauntering out and grabbed it. Stiff up.
That's a good fish. Nice.
Nice.
That's a really nice fish.
Yeah, I saw her come out and eat it. Look at that.
That works.
Thank you, little girl. Nice fish. Look at her tail.
Wow.
Thank you. Saunters off under the boat.
Hey folks, Glenn May here with BassResource.com. And today I want to talk about the top 5 inexpensive baits that I feel are budget friendly that will work for you throughout the entire spring. These are going to save you some money. And because of the versatility, you're going to be able to fish them, whether the fish are deep in the early part of the spring or up shallow spawning or somewhere in between, even in the post spawn. These are very effective. So they're budget friendly because they don't cost you a whole bunch. Plus they have a value to them because you can use them. They're very versatile. You can use them throughout the entire spring. So let's jump right into it. The first bait I want to talk about is the Yum Dinger. I really like the Yum Dinger for a variety of reasons. First of all, it's got that nice subtle action that all stick baits have, but even the ones that have a real soft plastic to them, it still has that action, but because it's not as uses that soft pliable plastic that some of the others use, it's more durable. You can catch several fish with it before it gets all tore up. So just by that nature, you're saving money, but also you can buy them in bulk. And when you buy them in bulk, they're only gonna be a couple pennies a piece. So it saves you a lot of money. As far as the versatility is concerned, early in the spring when the fish are deeper, you can tie it onto a split shot rig or a drop shot rig, get it down there deep where they are and work it deep along the creek channels, along those ledges, those humps, those main lake points that are entrances into those flats. And as the fish move up shallower, you can start to lighten up on the weight and then even fish it weightless when those fish are up in the flats feeding heavily, or even spawning. I just fish it weightless, Texas rig. Just throw it out there on slack line and just let it flutter straight down. It falls horizontally. Use a 2-aught or 3-aught hook. And you catch a lot of fish that way. There's not a lot of work you have to do to it. And in the post spawn, when these fish are guarding fry, you can twitch it right through the ball of fry. And there's usually an aggressive male nearby guarding him, and he's going to whack it. All I ask is if you're catching bedding bass or if you're catching a fish that are guarding fry, just make sure you let go of them right away so they can finish with what they're doing with the spawn. It's really important that they're able to continue and finish that spawn. This lure, by the way, works really well in bedding bass too. You can bring it over the beds and just annoy the crap out of them until they bite it.
Ooh.
Weeds. Nope, that was a fish. That absolutely was a fish. He's right there. He's guarding bass. Coming after your lure. Here, you got it. There you go.
Damn. He's an aggressive little thing.
Yeah.
Dang. Got you, little guy. Come hither. Come hither. I'll put you back so you can continue guarding. There we go. Gosh. Thank you, little guy. Now go guard. Go guard away.
So that's number one. The next lure I like to use that's inexpensive is a jig. I like Seabird's jigs. They don't cost you that much, under $5. They're made with strong hooks. They use wire ties for the skirts, so they don't wear out and break over time. I've had some baits for 5-10 years and they still work really well. So they're a bargain at only a couple bucks a piece. They're built right. So that's why I like Seabird's jigs. And again, you can fish them at all depths from 60 feet up to zero. And you can just changing the weight on them. So what I like to do is early spring, I'll use a heavier weight, like a half ounce, maybe even a 3/4 ounce football head jig where there aren't any weeds. And I just crawl along the bottom real slow, like a little lethargic crawdad. The football jig, what it'll do is it'll wobble back and forth just like that. And it just looks like a little crawdad that's just come out of its slumber from the winter time. And they're very vulnerable at this time. And that's when the fish are, that's when the bass are gorging on crawdads. So it's a great bait to use early spring. Later on, what I like to do is, my favorite is to flip and pitch jigs into heavy cover. Bushes, any kind of flooded trees, shrubs, any kind of cover I can find where the fish will be up in there, flipping and pitching jigs right back in there and getting them where they are at is a great way to fish them during the spring. And you can swim them. They're so versatile. You can swim it along docks. You can swim it through balls of bait fish. You can swim it post-spawn when the fish are aggressively going after bait fish to feed up for the summer and recover from the spawn. It's so versatile that it's worth getting some jigs and using them throughout the spring. You're going to catch a lot of fish that way.
Can't tell me there ain't no fish in here. You just can't tell me that. I don't buy it. There we go. See, I was just mentioning it.
He hit it right when
I was just
it hit the water.
Little buckaroo.
Yep, right when it hit the water.
Little buckaroo.
He's like, saw it incoming. He didn't help it. And if the fish are reluctant to bite, they generally will bite this. Now, if they don't want to, that's when I go to my next lure, and that's a tube. Tube jigs are very inexpensive. There's a variety of companies out there that make them. I like, you know, Outlaw Baits, Outcast Baits, there's a few others that make really good tubes. A lot of companies do, but they're very inexpensive regardless of who you buy from. And generally speaking, you can buy them in bulk. I like to buy them in the 100-pack. That's how much I like tubes. So they'll last you a long time. They don't get tore up that much, and they're very inexpensive. Just rig it on a jig head that's got the eye offset from, it's not in the front, but a little bit offset from the front. And it's just an open jig head, and with that, you get the spiral action when you drop it in the water. Looks like a dying bait fish. Throw it up next to docks, throw it next to those old drops on those weed edges, and just let it spiral and let it do its job. You don't have to do anything, just let it fall on slack line. For that reason, that's why I throw it on spinning tackle, so I can flip the bail and just let it fall. And that's a great way to catch them, especially if the fish are, again, like I said, when the fronts come through, maybe they were on top of the hump before the front came through. They'll move off to the sides or even right down to the base of the hump when those fronts come through. And those fish, if they're not actively attacking that jig, that's when the tube works really well, because you can put a little scent inside. When the fish bites it, it's squishy, it feels realistic. They hold on to it a little bit longer because it's got the scent in it, and you can get a better hook set on it. So a tube jig is kind of a killer secret lure that I use that catches a lot of fish. So, and it's inexpensive too.
There we go.
But right when I cast, of course. Going for the bigger girls, huh?
Yes, actually I am. All right, you ready to come in? Come on in.
Say hi.
Ooh.
Hi.
Come, Heather.
Oh. There you go.
All right.
Nice.
Yeah.
And you got the hook out.
I know. She's a cute little girl. Little guy.
Yeah.
I threw her out in the middle of nowhere. Undid my backlash.
Ooh.
And as I was reeling it in, it chased it to the boat.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
So I threw right back in front of it. And it hit it.
No kidding.
Yep. Chased it to the boat.
The next bait I like to use a lot during the spring that doesn't cost you an arm and leg is a spinner bait. Now, before you go, whoa, wait a minute, there's a lot of expensive spinner baits out there, because there are. There's a lot out there. But the ones I find that are the best bargain for you are the ones made by Booyah. And that's because they're built really well and they don't cost a whole lot. They have really strong hooks that don't bend out. They use quality ball bearings on their for where the blades attach. Their wires are strong so they don't bend. And most importantly, they run straight when you right out of the package. It's hard to find that in a bargain spinnerbait. But the Booyahs I found tend to fit all those categories right out of the package. And again, you can fish them throughout the entire spring. Heavier spinnerbait, slow rolling it earlier in the season, so 1/2 ounce, 3/4 ounce. And then when you get into when the fish are up shallow and the temperatures are up in the upper 50s into the 60s, burning it across weed beds, burning it along docks, as fast as you can through stump fields, can elicit some very vicious strikes. 3/8 ounce spinnerbait works great in those scenarios when the fish are up shallow. So, spinnerbait, great bait to use.
Hey, look at that. Got a little bucky boo. Got a little bucky boo.
There we go. A frog.
Not a frog.
Actually, it's a toad. So we want to be specific.
You got a little bucky boo on a toad.
He's hungry because that's a big toad for this guy. Well, take it.
Take it.
All right.
The next one I like to use during the spring, which isn't very expensive, is a frog. There's two main frogs I like, two brands of frogs. One is the Booyah Pad Crasher, and the other one is by Spro, the Bronze Eye. Spro, great bait to use because it's relatively inexpensive. The Bronze Eye costs a little bit more than the Pad Crasher, but you can get it on sale and that's a moot point. The thing is about these two baits is that they're very, very durable. So fish after fish after fish, they're not going to tear up and become unusable. They last a long time. The hooks are very strong. They don't bend out. So it makes it a great bargain because you can use them season after season after season. The thing about frogs in the spring is I fish them a lot earlier than most people do. I start fishing them when that water temperature gets above 50 degrees. Yeah, I know, right? Crazy. I fished a tournament last year and I caught most of my fish on big fish on frogs. They're all big fish. Biggest one was, you know, pushing over 6 pounds. And when I told people what I caught them on, they couldn't believe me because it was 52 degree water temps. Like, you're not fishing frogs, you liar. Okay. You know, what have I got to, you know, to gain by lying? So But that's the truth. Because what happens is those fish start moving up shallow and they move up into that cover. And all you need is a few days of nice weather like this, where maybe it's been, you know, terrible rain, cold, but you get 3 or 4 days in a row where the weather's been nice, or you get maybe several days of rain, but it's been warm. So it warms up that water quickly. All you need is a quick warm up where the water temperature changes several degrees in a short period of time, and that'll move the fish up shallow. And that's when they're susceptible to a frog. And that's what it was with that tournament situation. We had several warm days. We had 2 weeks actually of a warming trend when it rained really hard. Warm rain is going to warm up a lake a lot faster than a bluebird sunny day like today. So that's when I broke out that frog, because the temperatures went from 46 degrees to 52 in a week. So they all came up shallow. Frog City. Frog can be really fun even as you get, you know, closer into the, you know, into pre-spawn. And even when they're spawning, because it floats, you can bring it right on top of a bed and just park it right on top of the bed and just give it little subtle twitches with the rod tip and entice that bass to smack it. And you can bring it over tops of balls of fry during post-spawn, bring it over those weeds that are now emerging, and bring it in little pockets of those weeds and let it sit. Just give it little twitches. It looks like a little something that's struggling, some amphibian. Boom, those bass will suck it right up. So frog is a great lure to use, inexpensive to use throughout the entire season. Okay, so those are my top 5 inexpensive lures to use during the spring. I hope those tips help. For more tips and tricks like this, visit bassresource.com.